Once upon a time, in a small village nestled deep within the mountains, there lived a young man named Zenji. Zenji was an ordinary villager, working in the fields and tending to his family's modest farm. Life in the village was peaceful, yet Zenji couldn't shake off a lingering feeling of restlessness. He yearned for something more, something beyond the boundaries of his simple existence. One day, Zenji heard tales of a renowned Zen master who resided atop a nearby mountain. The master was said to possess extraordinary wisdom and insight, capable of guiding seekers towards enlightenment. Intrigued by the possibility of discovering a deeper meaning to life, Zenji decided to embark on a journey to meet the Zen master. The path to the mountaintop was treacherous, winding through dense forests and steep cliffs. Zenji endured physical hardships, braving the elements with unwavering determination. As he climbed higher, the air grew thin, and the surroundings transformed into a realm of breathtaking beauty. The vibrant colors of wildflowers danced in the wind, and the songs of birds echoed through the valleys. After days of arduous travel, Zenji finally reached the Zen master's humble dwelling. The master, a serene and gentle old man, welcomed Zenji with a warm smile. They sat together, overlooking the vast expanse of nature below, as the master brewed tea and poured it into delicate cups. "Zenji," the master began, "you have come seeking wisdom. But true wisdom cannot be found in words alone. It is an experiential journey that requires self-reflection and inner exploration." Zenji listened intently, eager to absorb the master's teachings. The master continued, "To discover the true essence of life, you must learn to be present in each moment. Let go of your attachments to the past and the future. The present is where true enlightenment resides." In the following weeks, Zenji became the Zen master's devoted disciple. Under the master's guidance, he learned the art of meditation and mindfulness. He immersed himself in the simplicity of each task, finding beauty in the mundane. From sweeping the temple floor to tending the garden, Zenji embraced every act as an opportunity for self-discovery. As the months passed, Zenji's understanding deepened. The master's lessons transcended the boundaries of traditional teaching, as he often utilized poetic metaphors and riddles to convey profound truths. Zenji gradually began to see the interconnectedness of all things, recognizing that he was an integral part of the grand tapestry of existence. One evening, as Zenji and the master sat in silence, gazing at the setting sun, the master shared one final piece of wisdom. "Zenji, life is a precious gift. Just as a farmer tends to his crops with care, nurturing the seeds to yield a bountiful harvest, you too must cherish your own vitality. Be mindful of how you invest your energy, both physically and mentally." Zenji pondered the master's words deeply. He realized that his journey towards enlightenment required not only inner exploration but also responsible choices in all aspects of his life. With newfound awareness, Zenji resolved to honor the gift of life by nurturing his physical and mental well-being. Years later, Zenji had become a Zen master in his own right. He had embraced the teachings he had received, sharing his wisdom with those who sought enlightenment. Through his guidance, many individuals found solace and a deeper understanding of their existence. In conclusion, the story of Zenji serves as a reminder that true wisdom and enlightenment are not merely intellectual pursuits. They require a commitment to self-discovery, presence in each moment, and responsible stewardship of one's energy. Just as Zenji found his path through the guidance of a Zen master, we too can find our own way by embracing the simplicity and beauty of life, nourishing our vitality, and treading the path with purpose.
For loves and supports, please like this video and subscribe my YouTube channel to get more valuable information.